estas ganas horribles de llamarte.
Tómale, tómale, compadre, no se me queda atrás, hijo.
When the stars align, the bitch, you better be ready. I won't take my time, the bitch, you know I'm ready. I'm winning right now, the bitch, you know I'm ready. See, my flag the same color as Grand Bear. You call on by my gang, it's Hail Mary. Them niggas not no thugs, they some fairies. I'm playing with them birds like on Larry. We pop right by the curb.
What is good, YouTube? Today we're gonna be doing another tier list ranking videos. This time we're gonna be doing it on shoes. So I've never done one on shoes yet. This video, we're gonna be doing it on pretty much all the Van shoes. The ones that I haven't skated and aren't gonna be in this video are gonna be the Skate Highs, the Grosso Mids, and I haven't skated the Chukka Lows in so long that I don't really remember what they feel like. So aside from those, there's gonna be pretty much every other shoe. And keep in mind, Vans skate shoes are only the pro models. So if it's a Vans Classic, it's not a skate shoe and I didn't skate it. Practically every shoe is gonna be on this list that I've skated from Vans, and I've skated a lot. So let's get right into it. All right, the first shoe I'm gonna be talking about is the classic Vans Old School Pro. I haven't skated this shoe in about 2 years, but I remember you got that suede on the toe, and then you got a bunch of canvas along the side, along with the Vans stripe. I actually really like this shoe. I thought it skated really good, mainly because I do a lot of kick flips and not heel flips. I feel like if I did a lot of heel flips, that side would have worn a lot quicker and the Van stripe would have fallen off. It just would have been a little messy, but since the toe cap was super clean, no stitches, just a solid pad of suede, the flick was solid and it skated really good. I really liked the way that the sole felt on this one. It wasn't a bad shoe. Lately I've grown to like a little bit more padding on the sides of my shoe and not have these super thin ones anymore. That being said, I would definitely buy this shoe again. It wasn't bad at all. I'm thinking for this shoe, I'm probably gonna go at a nice solid because I would easily buy it again. It skated real nice and it was an overall decent shoe. I'd recommend it for sure. I like most of these Vans. They're good. Van shoes. They know what's up. That's why I always skate them. All right, now on to the last shoe that I skated before the one that I'm on now, which I haven't done a review on yet, which is this good old fashioned Ave. So I actually skated this shoe quite a bit and you can see it's not that worn. I actually stopped skating it because the right shoe, I went through the toe and it was starting to bug me. So that was the main reason that this shoe got retired. Which sucks that that happens a lot. No matter how durable they make this side, if I go through the bottom, I can't repair that. Side is always repairable with shoe goo. So these right here are pretty much Van's most expensive skate shoe. They're like the top of the line. They sort of look like a running shoe. And I remember when I first got them, I saw this side and it felt really grippy. I was like, oh, this is gonna be an excellent shoe. Yeah, I scooped it thinking it was gonna be one of the best Van shoe that I've ever skated. But right out the bat, I noticed that it had a big problem with flick. This material right here is kind of like suede. It has a suede feel, but it's not normal suede. It's like a stronger material, which is why it's like as expensive as the way that it is. But it doesn't flick that good. It kind of feels like, I kept saying when I was skating it, it feels like I have a bar of soap on my shoe. Like it wasn't gripping the board the way that I normally get with that Vans sole, where it's just this long rubber thing and my kick flips are like effortless. Like I'll just go up and it grips the board the whole time. These ones felt closer to how a Nike SB Team Classic skates, but arguably less grip on the flick. They wouldn't be a terrible shoe, but if you take in how much they cost to how they skate, I'm gonna put them at average because I'm probably not gonna spend that kind of money to buy this shoe again. So because of the cost and the flaws in the flick, I'll put it at average. But it still is a durable shoe, so it's not terrible. All right, now on to one of the Vans that I've skated more than any other Vans, It's the Kyle Walker original one. This shoe, I remember skating a lot back to back to back. It's a relatively thin cup sole and everything about it is decent. Durability was decent. It was overall like just built well. It had nice flick. I'm gonna just say right out the bat, this shoe was solid. It was not like the best shoe I've ever skated by Vans, but easily like one that I could recommend, and it's gonna get you where you need to go. Decent. Yeah, it's just a nice little solid cup sole. I like the way that it skates. So going off of the Kyle Walker number one, now I'm gonna talk about the Kyle Walker two, which pretty much the only difference is it has a Velcro strap instead of laces. I actually haven't tried this shoe yet, but from what I hear, it skates very similar, pretty much the same as the regular Kyle Walker, but you don't really have to worry about the laces. I personally don't want to get this shoe because I think it looks a bit uglier than the Kyle Walker regular with laces. Seeming that it skates the same and it's all personal preference, I'm gonna keep it at solid, but I'm gonna put it like right below the Kyle Walker number one just because I like the way that one looks better. That one's a personal preference thing. Some people might think the two is a better deal. I don't really like the way it looks. It's a lower solid. All right, next up, we're gonna be talking about the next shoe that I'm skating, which I've skated once before, and that is the Burl Pro model. I haven't even tried this shoe on yet, but I got like a Vans outlet close to me, so that's part of the reason why I skate so many Vans. It's got this nice slim little toe cap around it, which I think helped a lot with my grip the first time I had it. It's also got this little special waffle cup. I don't remember what it's called, but I remember that this also helped a lot with my grip, and I really like those grippy shoes. I think it was a little stronger under the toe too, so it took more time to break through this little like pain zone, I call it. Like I said before, when you go through here, the shoe is done. You can't really fix it. This shoe had a really good flick, nice solid couple layers to protect against going through the top, and a decent amount of padding on the tongue and sides and just overall around the shoe. One of the things I didn't like too much was how the insole is sort of stitched in there. So it's like a part of the shoe, so you can't really take it out. It's like the insole is built into the shoe. So it wasn't terrible. I just thought it felt a little weird the first time I wore it. And I was like, the sole feels slightly harder, but while skating like gaps or anything, it wasn't a problem. And I don't know why I haven't skated again in a while. It was a great shoe. And I think personally, this is the first one I'm gonna put up at that legendary spot, because it sort of checks all the marks for me on what makes a great skate shoe. All right, up next, I'm gonna be talking about the Vans Slip-On Pro. So every time I've skated this shoe, it actually has been a better experience than what I always anticipate. The one thing is with sizing, since it doesn't have laces, you should probably go like a half size smaller. It's a little bit tricky to get like a size that fits perfect. Even after you break it in, you're like, oh, this shoe's no problem. It skates pretty good, and the one of the best things about it, it has padding right where you need it, which is like right along that heel line. And that little bit of padding helps a lot, especially with like heel flips and such. If that padding isn't there, it's usually a pretty painful experience, but it kick flips good. It had decent durability. The grip was good on the outsole. And with the Ultra Cush insole, you could even get away with skating some gaps. It was a pretty solid skate shoe, to be honest. I don't want to really give it an average, so it's definitely solid. Some people might like a little more than me, some people might like it a little less. I thought it was right in that spot where it's a good thin skate shoe and not overly thin, even though it's a slip-on. Yeah, it's a weird shoe. I don't know how they did it. All right, now to go off on the slip-on, we're going next to the Authentic Pro. This shoe, I skated 2 times in a row. Don't know why, I think it's just because I found it at the outlet for cheap and it was in my size, so I got it. This shoe is okay for most kick flips, tray flips, ledge skating, not really for gap skating, and downright painful on heel flips because it has no padding anywhere. You're basically wearing a sock attached to a Pro Vans sole. If you've skated these and you love them, like that's good on you. I thought they were very average. Like if you can't do like all the basic like flip tricks in them without them like kind of hurting, then that's a problem. And the durability was also kind of average. It was just missing that padding. It wasn't that I don't really, if I have a choice, I'm not gonna skate it again. So that was the good old authentic pro, right at average. Now that I'm thinking about it, you got two levels to the authentic pro. You got the authentic pro in suede, which I'm easily saying average, and then you got the authentic pro in all canvas. And I hate the way canvas skates. So you take a shoe that I already think is average, and then you change the material to one that's not as good. Now you got what I would consider no good. So authentic pro in canvas, I'ma just put a no good. As far as Vans go, it's still all right. Like it's better than, I would rather have a canvas authentic pro than some other brands of skate shoes. But if you're choosing a Vans, there's a lot of better ones. I probably wouldn't go with that one. That's just my opinion though. All right, now talking about the Vans Era Pro, which takes the problem with the authentic and fixes it by putting a little bit of padding on the heel. So this shoe, just for that reason, immediately goes up to solid. Yeah, it just, that slight little padding makes all the difference in the world for me. So it's just a simple, solid shoe, Era Pro. Okay, if you didn't see in my last video, this is the shoe I'm running now. For the first time ever, I should have skated this shoe years ago. I don't know how this was the first time I ever had it. They're trending a lot right now. Everyone's got some half caps. These ones I got at the outlet for cheaper. They look pretty cool. That mid top is very helpful. It actually protected me from shark bite on two occasions, which was just the best feeling in the world when the board hits your ankle and it doesn't really hurt that bad. So they definitely are one of the, probably the bulkiest shoe on this list. They got padding everywhere. Vans have some problems where a few of them will give me a blister on the first 2 days of breaking, because they got this big plastic piece down here, and when they're just stiff new shoes, like that happens. So these shoes did not give me a blister because they just have so much padding. It was easy to break in. You got this huge vulcanized outsole, which flicks decently well. I wouldn't say it's the best flicking Vans, but it flips well. And you got this double stitch suede. You can see that's where my big toe hits on kick flips, because I like really wrap my foot around when I do them. But yeah, they skate street good. They skate transition good. They got a very good amount of padding so your feet don't get too sore. You can see I got some sweat stains here though, because since they are a little bulkier, they get a little hotter in the summer, but it's not really a problem because mainly when I get hot in the summer, I'm more focused on how my head feels than how any other part of my body feels. So this is a great shoe. It's being pretty durable right now too. I've had it for about 3 weeks or 2 weeks, something along there, but in the summer I skate a lot more, so it's holding up very well. The laces are ripping a little bit, but I still haven't had to change a pair yet. So the lace placement is decent. I think these are the second edition, which has the pop sole, pop cush sole, which is a slightly better version of the ultra cush. And yeah, it's a great shoe. This one's an easy legendary for me. This one is honestly priced second place on all my Vans right now. If I could go to the store and pick a pair, it's gonna be between this and the top place, which I'll talk about later. Great shoe. All right, now onto the Chima Pro 2, which is a very elegant shoe for all your flip tricks. It has a pretty pristine flick. It has good durability because there's no stitching along anywhere in the toe box or anything like that. Super good for heel flips too, because it's just suede on the whole thing. You got that slight little toe cap, which I think makes a decent difference in the durability of a shoe if you do a lot of kick flips, and it just looks good. It's got good padding. Yeah, this one's an easy legendary. Okay, now on to my all-time favorite Vans shoe. The Vans Rowan Pro. All right, so this shoe I'm pretty sure was designed off of the Half Cap Pro, and they just took this very slight flaws on the Half Cap and made it even better. They got triple stitching along most of the shoe, which actually helps a lot with durability. I remember looking at this shoe and in the middle of the toe cap on mine, there was like some mesh material, and I was like, oh, that's gonna be no good. This shoe is gonna blow out. And it didn't even come close to blowing out. This was one of the longest lasting Vans I've ever had, all around, under the sole, at that danger point I'm talking about, just along the side, everywhere. This shoe lasted so long. The flip was pristine. It was flipping so good on my kickflips. It was even good on my heel flips. It was just good on all my flip tricks. I could skate whatever I want. Transition, like stairs, rails, ledges, everything had just the right amount of feel on it. And if I were to get any Van shoe forever, this is the one I'm sticking with. It also is, it's a low top. It's not mid like the half cab, but it kind of has like this straight edge along the ankle line. So it's very slightly higher, which helps a little bit with protection too. It's just overall easily my favorite Vans, and I like the way it looks a lot. So this one's easily my top tier legendary Vans. There are some of you that probably skipped this video just to see what my favorite one is. Screw you, should have watched the whole thing and figured out which ones that I didn't like as much as this one. So yeah, that's it for the list. All right, so I hope you guys like this video. We got new vids every week, trying to get to 20K ASAP. Yeah, make sure to follow the gram, subscribe, like the video, drop a comment below, do all those cool things, and see you guys on the next one. Peace out, mates.